Καλησπέρα σας. Good afternoon from Drexel University. My name is Dr. Maria Hnaraki. I'm the Director of Greek Studies, and we are here. We just finished an event on Cyprus. We had several guests from Cyprus, Israel, and Greece that they spoke, and they focused on not that much the economic crisis, but the, you know, the perspectives of the situation, especially focusing on the gas fields and all the energy that is related to that part of the world. I'm here with Honorable Aristos Constantine from New York City, who is going to give us some of his ideas on you know, the event and briefly talk to us about what he presented earlier on today.
Well, thank you, Maria. And first, I'd like to thank Drexel University. I mean, this is, I believe, the only Hellenic program in the country, and I think you do a fantastic job, and we're happy to be here to support you, and we definitely appreciate your support. I think the event was outstanding. I think it was timely in that it gave us the opportunity to address, as you said, multiple issues that I think there's a curiosity, and there was a need to set the record straight, especially when it came to the economic crisis and Cyprus's good name and our future mm-hmm. prospects. Overall, I think the panel was excellent, and we managed to bring together a varied and broad spectrum of views. Mm-hmm. I think we've covered just about everything there is to cover today, mm-hmm. and I think it was well received.
Well, if you're looking at the developments as they're taking place in Cyprus, and not only in Cyprus but the Eastern Mediterranean as a whole, you have vast amounts of hydrocarbons that has been discovered, which opens up for new possibilities and new industries throughout the region. It also opens for great possibility for regional corporations. We've seen this between Israel and Cyprus, but also between Cyprus and Lebanon, and of course for Greece this is very important because of the close relationship between Cyprus and Greece, and I believe that these discoveries, especially offshore Cyprus, could help bring Greece and Cyprus closer together and promoting and giving them a bigger role in the European continent and in the region.
The exclusive economic zone is a kind of a new concept that started when the United Nations created a convention of the law of the sea that it gives rights to countries and to their islands to have an area for exclusive rights for the mineral resources, for fisheries and the environment. And there are 134 countries today that have proclaimed an exclusive economic zone, one of them, of course, being Cyprus. United States is one, Russia is one, many countries of the European Union, and unfortunately Greece has not declared one yet. And it needs to declare it, because if you don't declare and proclaim an exclusive economic zone, then you cannot delimit that exclusive economic zone with other nations.
I think this is a great opportunity for all the three nations, Israel, Greece and Cyprus, to get even closer together and to use the energy discoveries as an engine for growth, both in terms of economic collaboration and geostrategic goals in the region.
Do you think this geostrategic collaboration will lead to even more sorts of collaborations and projects in that part of the world?
In fact, it's already happening. You see more and more collaboration between Greek and Cypriot institutions and Israeli institutions. You see more officials and politicians from these countries visit their counterparts. So I think this trend will continue regardless what's happening in other parts of the region.
I am Stavros Antonakakis. Congratulations to Drexel. The Greek Studies program under the direction of Dr. Maria Hnaraikis and the wonderful work that Professor Katerinakis has done to bring another outstanding panel discussing the economic situation in the Mediterranean and in particular in Cyprus. Aphrodite mates the Leviathan. I found it amazing the amount of information that's available and how relevant it is to the geoeconomic and geopolitical situation, and how critical it is for us to continue to support the country of Cyprus and, of course, the issues related to Greece and in relation to that area.
Stelios Tsinantidis, and I am the president of the Cyprus Society of Greater Philadelphia. I would also like to thank Dr. Hnaraki for organizing this outstanding event and the panelists who graciously share their experiences and their ideas about Cyprus and the hydrocarbon fields and how these can change the political aspects of the Cyprus problem and the geopolitical aspects of the region. I thank them for their thoughtful insights of how we could utilize this opportunity to bring about a just solution for the Cyprus problem, as it is the elephant in the room, as someone identified during the discussion. We really need to give our support to our leaders throughout the region and hopefully utilize these hydrocarbon fields to promote a just solution for Cyprus and peace in the region. Thank you very much and congratulations for this outstanding event. Thank you.
I'm here with two of the attendees of tonight's events who are Drexel students at the International Area Studies Program, Rebecca Olsho and Elias Okwara. And they are going to talk to us about their thoughts in terms of this event, particularly in regards to their majors, International Area Studies. Rebecca?
Okay, so I'm a freshman in International Area Studies, and I will be doing research this summer with Maria in Greece on how what we were just talking about, how the oil deposits have affected, I guess, each country politically and economically and environmentally. So I came out here just to hear all their opinions and thoughts on it, and I thought it was a great experience and really interesting.
Thank you. Ilya?
So my interest has always been peace and security, security and defense issues. And this program was particularly interesting because you could also see how very important issues of conflict around the world can possibly get resolved when you have economic cooperation. And that was something very interesting where you have the application of these international norms and agreements that bring about cooperation.
Thank you both very much.
Thank you.